What's up guys, Dirk here from Intelligent Cryptocurrency. I wasn't gonna make a video today, but I saw a tweet from Michael Saylor saying they bought another $50 million worth of Bitcoin. And you know, I thought, okay, let me make a video because all this news is so bullish. And you know, we're kind of hovering just under this 20,000 and people are starting to wonder, you know, what's happening, alt season isn't here yet. And that kind of thing. So let me dive into some articles here. I'm gonna keep this video relatively short just to reaffirm how bullish this really is. And I think 2021 is going to be a phenomenal year for cryptocurrencies. So if you're new to the channel, my name is Dirk, and if you haven't subscribed yet, just click that subscribe button, click the notification bell. It's completely free if you want to continue to get updates and no BS crypto content. So let me dive straight into this because this just came out, as you can see here, December 5th, 2020, Michael Saylor, CEO of MicroStrategy, has purchased approximately 2,574 Bitcoins for $50 million in cash in accordance with its Treasury Reserve policy at an average price of $19,427 per Bitcoin. We now hold approximately 40,824 Bitcoin, right? So, insane. So there's a couple of things here that are very, very important. First of all, they're a huge publicly listed company on the NASDAQ. They started buying a couple months ago at around $10,000. They've invested more than $425 million. I think it's now it's $475 million into Bitcoin because they believe, Michael Saylor said this, that holding on to fiat currency, US dollars, is just holding it like holding on to a melting ice cube because it's just getting less and less. The more that central banks are printing fiat currencies, the more the purchasing power gets devalued. And basically, to paraphrase, he's saying like if you're holding on to fiat currencies, well, you're devaluing at 10, 15, 20% a year and you're losing that purchasing power. So when you have that much cash assets at your disposal, where are you going to invest it in for the longer term, right? We're not talking about, you know, the next 6 or 12 months. It's talking about, you know, for the next 50 or 100 years, where do you put that to make sure that your purchasing power is secured? And the answer to that is Bitcoin. They have purchased a total now of 40,824 Bitcoin. And that is money that they're taking out of that Bitcoin supply. Because as you know, there's only going to be 21 million Bitcoin ever, right? And that is only by the year 2140. So all this Bitcoin won't even be available for most of our lifetimes, but the majority will be, of course. And that is it, okay? There are more than 21 million millionaires in the USA alone. So there is not enough Bitcoin for everyone to have a piece of it. And that is why the price can go so much higher. Supply and demand, right? There's a limited supply, and if the demand keeps increasing, the price goes up. That's basic economics. And the cool thing is there's no central entity, no government, no central bank, no CEO, nobody who can create more Bitcoin. It's hard printed into the code. It's coded in, you know, into the software. 21 million Bitcoin is all there will ever be. And when we start seeing this interest, as we've been seeing over the last couple months with institutions and funds and billionaires starting to buy this, it's, you know, there's not going to be enough Bitcoin for them to continue buying like this. They have hundreds of millions, billions of dollars that is a melting ice cube, basically, that's just dropping in purchasing power every single year. And that money has to go somewhere if it wants to preserve its purchasing power, right? So if companies are going to start doing this and putting this more into Bitcoin, well, what do you think is going to happen to the price, right? And the thing that I wanted you to note here also is they bought this $50 million at $19,427. That is pretty much the all-time high of 2017. And that is very much near the high that we recently touched. So if they're willing to buy at $20,000, what is that telling you about their view of Bitcoin, right? What is that telling you about their attitude towards Bitcoin? And sure, maybe it'll drop in the short term. It's not a guarantee that it's only going to go up from here. But they're basically saying, we're so confident that we are going to buy $50 million worth of this digital currency, Bitcoin, and we're going to hold that, right? And whether it drops in the short term, whatever, it doesn't matter. Their expectation is that in the long run, that is going to preserve their purchasing power, or that it's going to increase in value, right? That's the logic behind it. Why else would they, you know, be willing to buy at this level? So if they're doing it and other companies are just getting started with this, you know, and running this through their board approval meetings and then the shareholder meetings and making their decisions, who knows, you know, we're going to start seeing institutions and companies buying Bitcoin at $25,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000. And as long as there's this increased demand, which is really this institutional kind of FOMO that we're starting to see, how high can the price of Bitcoin go, right? Especially keeping in mind that Bitcoin is incredibly, incredibly scarce, and the dangers associated with holding fiat currency are getting worse and worse and worse. People who have this knowledge, right, they're not stupid. They understand what is happening with the fiat currency system. CEOs and millionaires and billionaires, they understand that fiat currency is just going to get worth less and less and less. And the more that central banks are printing, the less their purchasing power is going to become. They understand this, right? So what are your options? Stocks, real estate, precious metals, right? There's obviously different investment vehicles, but Bitcoin is starting to look now like it is really becoming an asset of choice to hedge yourself against inflation and to park some of your cash to preserve its purchasing power and hopefully benefit from the rise up, especially combine that with the scarcity of Bitcoin and the global nature of it. You know, the fact that it's unconfiscatable, you can hold your own Bitcoin, like no bank can just freeze your Bitcoin for you, you know. So all these things are going to play a massive, massive factor, in my opinion. And I think this is just really showing that we are going to go way, way higher in the coming months and years. And sure, there could be dips in the meantime, but overall, you know, since Bitcoin started, in the long run, if you just bought and held, look where it's gone, right? $1,000, $5,000, $10,000, now almost $20,000. I think that it's very, very likely we're going to see $50,000, $100,000 per Bitcoin in the future. When, I don't know. It could be next year. It could be 5 years from now. But, you know, just seeing how this is all playing out, I mean, it's all pointing towards that. Let me show you some other things here. So Grayscale, they're just buying millions, hundreds of millions of dollars worth of Bitcoin. Obviously, they're buying this on behalf of their clients. It's not them doing it themselves. But we've just been seeing week after week after week new Bitcoin being acquired by Grayscale. Then we have Paul Tudor Jones makes the bull case for Bitcoin. You can see this on Yahoo Finance. The path forward from here is north. He's embracing a HODL mentality on Bitcoin. And you can see over here, he says he told Yahoo Finance that he expects a digital coin will be substantially higher in 20 years. I mean, 20 years is a long time period, but again, that kind of reiterates that these billionaires and funds and companies who are buying, they don't have a 6 month time frame or a 1 year time frame. They're looking 10, 20, 50, maybe even 100 years for that, potentially even that generational wealth. And they understand fiat currencies. We've seen it in history over and over again. Go and study fiat currencies. Look what has happened in Turkey, in Venezuela, in Argentina. Look what has happened in Zimbabwe, right? It is the nature of fiat currency, the system. It is flawed by design. It's based on a debt-based system. The more they print, at some point, it's just unsustainable, and the value of that fiat currency is just gone, right? And it starts to accelerate. It goes slowly, 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 and then parabolic in the loss of the purchasing power. And this year alone, I mean, central banks have printed more than in the last 2 centuries, okay? That's how it's going. The acceleration is crazy, and we are not yet seeing it at a crazy hyperinflation level. Like, when we go to the supermarket, it's not like $100 to buy an egg yet. You know, who knows what's going to happen in the future. So maybe that's why, you know, if you don't study this stuff and you're not aware of it, you don't actually know that it's happening, but it is happening, right? What is the consequence? You can't just print $20 trillion or whatever it is that they've printed this year out of thin air, put that into the economy and have no consequence for the value of the purchasing power, right? It's just impossible. That is why it's so, so important to be aware of it and, of course, to subscribe to my channel so you get updates in the future. But, yeah, Paul Tudor Jones, billionaire, okay? Raoul Paul, okay? This is a very good podcast over here, interview, I guess, whatever you want to call it, by Anthony Pompliano. If you haven't watched it yet, I'll leave the link in the description. Go and check it out. It's basically an hour and 20 minutes where he interviews Raoul Paul about Bitcoin. And basically, Raoul Paul is basically saying that he thinks Bitcoin is going to $1 million, and he put 10% of Real Vision invested 10% of its cash holdings into Bitcoin, right? So he actually also personally put a heck of a lot of money. He's mostly in Bitcoin from what I understand. So he's not only making these predictions, he's actually putting his money where his mouth is. And once again, this is not just some random person who creates YouTube videos, right? This is a very smart, very experienced, very intelligent, very well-researched investor. And he's making these moves, right? So you want to see where is smart money going? What is smart money doing? And for those of you early to crypto, you know, we've been seeing this in 2017 already, and then we were early, and some of us were already saying, you know, like, hey, crypto is the future. It's just going to take long for people to realize that. And then, yes, we had the boom. It was premature, basically, in terms of institutional kind of investments. But the last 3 years, that has all changed. I mean, the infrastructure has been built out, there's custodial services, the compliance is there, banks are getting involved, PayPal, and it's just all here now. So it's starting to happen. We're also starting to see the last 3 years, the enormous acceleration of the central bank, the money printing that's starting to happen. And it's all just, you know, on this path for, you know, a disaster with fiat currencies and for Bitcoin to go way up as a hedge against that and as a kind of a counter for that. Over here, Willy Woo, really good. If you want to follow him on Twitter, he's got a lot of good insights. And you can see over here, basically, he says the top model suggesting $200,000 by the end of 2021 looks conservative. Again, you never really know if these price targets are going to get hit. But again, based on everything I've shown you, what is going to start happening if dozens or hundreds or thousands of institutions and funds around the world are going to start? You know, investing tens of millions or hundreds of millions into Bitcoin at a time. Like, what is that going to do? Crypto is such a small market right now, and this is what we've been waiting for. Literally, these billions of dollars of real money to start flowing into it, and it could go quickly, right? It could go really quickly based on what I'm showing you. So, will it happen by the end of 2021? I wish I could tell you that I know the future, because you know, then I'd be super rich, and so would you if I actually knew the future, but I don't. So whether it's gonna happen, you know, next year, or whether it's gonna take another few more years, but we've all seen the craziness of this year. Nobody ever expected whatever happened this year. All this craziness with the lockdowns and the shutdowns and all that craziness, that came out of nowhere. And you see how that's basically completely transformed the world in the period of 12 months. So who knows what lies ahead? It can happen very, very quickly. If it does, you know, I'm okay with $200,000 Bitcoin, right? Just send it, please. But you know, this is what is possible. And again, based on previous cycles and what's happening, it's starting to look more and more realistic. One other thing here also, Bitcoin's held on spot exchanges. So the amount of Bitcoin held on exchanges here was also, it was dropping before the massive pump of 2017. And we are starting to see this now, which means that again, everything I've shown you lining up could potentially be here for a massive, massive bull run in the next 1 to 2 years. And just some more articles here. Legacy German bank to start a crypto fund next year. This came out literally 2 days ago. The S&P Dow Jones indices to launch cryptocurrency indexes in 2021. I mean, if this isn't a stamp of approval that, hey, crypto is here to stay, Bitcoin, it's all going mainstream, it is here. I don't know, right? We're just seeing this over and over again. It is here. It is now, in my opinion, this is all just a stamp of approval. Bitcoin, digital assets, cryptocurrencies, they're here, and they're going to get a heck of a lot bigger in the coming years. And, you know, if you're not yet involved, this is your time to position yourself, because once it takes off and once it gets to a few $1 trillion in market cap, and if Bitcoin is at $50,000 or $100,000 and Ethereum is trading at a few $1,000s per ETH, the chances of making those exponential gains are much harder, if not completely gone. And you might still be able to get 5 or 10x, but we're talking about, you know, being able to get 30, 50, 100x on some of these altcoins, which, by the way, still haven't started moving yet. I don't think there's a lot of time left. Hopefully, we'll start to see that in the next couple of weeks, the next couple of months. The period of December, January is usually a period when altcoins have a chance to pop. So hopefully, we'll see that. Another one, Japanese finance giant to offer Bitcoin loans. The SBI Group will soon be offering Bitcoin lending services. So you can see the banks, PayPal, billionaires, institutions, they're all getting involved. So that is my update for today. I just want to show you how incredibly bullish this is. Patience is key. It might still take a few months. It might still take a year or 2 years, but it is coming. I mean, everything is pointing towards crypto just going mainstream and becoming much, much bigger than it is today. So I hope you have an awesome Saturday. Have an awesome weekend. Smash the like button if you haven't done so already. Leave a comment if you have any questions or feedback. And if you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button, click the notification bell so you can get my future updates. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.